Hey there, do you send emails to a group of people who don't know each other? A good example could be sending your clients a company newsletter or invites to a company event. If you do, I'm going to share with you how to make sure you don't upset anyone by sharing their private information with all of the recipients of your email. Pretty good, right? Hey, I'm Sharyn from Excel at Work, where we offer straightforward, non-technical assistance to help you become a confident, super productive, and super safe user of Microsoft Office. In this video, I'm going to run through a scenario of sending a message out to a group of people who don't know each other. I'll show you how you can hide email addresses and confidently send messages to the group. Knowing private information is kept private. And if you personally have further tips that may be really helpful to others, go ahead and share them in the comments below. We'd love to hear from you. Hello there. Well, here I am in Outlook, and I want to talk you through a scenario. This actually comes from me going out and doing, you know, workshops in Outlook, and I just hear way too often people telling me that they've done this and they've got into trouble, and I don't want that to be you. So let's talk about if we were creating a new email. I'm just going to go up here and click onto new email, and if we were creating a new email to a group of people that didn't know each other. And what I mean by that is, like, a good example of that would be like if you're sending out the company newsletter or maybe an invite to a company event. And the last thing you'd want to do is copy and paste everybody's email addresses into the to field or the CC field. Because what happens is when people receive the message, they can actually see all the email addresses that have been popped into both of those fields. So I'm going to introduce you to a new field. So if I just go up to the options tab, and I'll just, if you're in an earlier version, you probably will see the full ribbon. So I'm just going to click onto the BCC field. Now, it depends on which school you went to, I think, what you call BCC. Some people call it blind courtesy copy. Some people call it blind carbon copy. I think the blind bit is the bit that we're kind of focusing on here. So I'm going to click it on, and now it'll be in the message pane. So we can easily kind of like populate information into it. So this is the thing that I want you to do from now on. If you are going to be sending messages out to multiple people who don't know each other, please don't put the addresses in here. So for example, if I went, obviously there's myself, but I'm just pretending, and I went Duncan, maybe, and who's another person that's in there? I'll just use one of our training. He's Teddy Bear. Okay, so if I actually grabbed those three people and they didn't know each other, what could happen is if I send that out, you know, just like company newsletter type thing, and then just put an attachment on it, what can happen is one of these three people or multiple people could get very upset that you've just shared their private details with people they don't know. In fact, I was doing some training for a law firm, and one of the lawyers there said to me, we were in a workshop, in a large workshop, and one of the lawyers there said to me that he'd received a newsletter from his gym, and his email address was in the to field at the top, and he was not happy, and he let them know it. I don't know if I'd want to hear from a lawyer that was unhappy. So here we go. This is what I would prefer to see you doing. So obviously, I mean, if I just go like that and just pick them up and drag them, I can drag them down into the BCC field. Of course, that's one way to do it. Or you can just start typing people's names into the BCC field. So I'm just going to pop Duncan's name in there. And what a lot of people do is they actually put their own email address up here in the to field. So that means that when people receive it, it'll only show your email address, and of course it's come from you anyway, so it's no big deal. And down here they will not be able to see any of the email addresses that have been popped into that field. Now if this was an agenda of some kind, and people did need to actually see who was going to be there, it'd be fine to actually say, oh, oopsie, I should put my email, my insertion point down here. I could actually put down in here, you know, attending, and then I could actually put, you know, people's names in here, but it's only their names. It actually hasn't got their private information. So that's an idea. You don't have to, but it's just an idea. So if I just, so just remembering that this is obviously going off to Duncan, so I'll just click the send button. And off it goes. Now, obviously, you'll get a copy back to you as well. So if we just wait for that to come in. So you can see straight away that there is no way that others can actually see those email addresses. That's all they see is the two up the top there, which has got obviously Anne's address in there, and that's it. That's all they see. So if I just pop down to, I've just got Duncan's Gmail address. There it is there. So that's the company newsletter that's come in. I didn't actually put the attachment on. Isn't that embarrassing when you do that? Right, okay. So I'm just going to open that up. And again, it's got two Anne, but I can't see anybody else's information in there. So that's pretty cool. And of course, that's going to keep you safe. It's going to keep their information safe. And it looks very professional as well when people can see that you are actually protecting their private information. Hey, look, and while we're in Gmail, look at this. If I go compose, look, it's over here. So if you're a Gmail user, you know, like maybe for your private email information, and maybe you're even looking after a club or something like that, then of course you can just do BCC and do exactly the same thing in there, and the exact kind of the exact same result will happen. So I hope you found that helpful, and it's really important to us that we keep you safe. So if you've never seen this before, start using it. In fact, what I would suggest you do is maybe make sure that in your every time you use new, the BCC is left on. So of course you can turn it on and turn it off. You just go to options and it's a toggle, turn it on, turn it off. But if, at least if it's there, you start thinking, don't you, maybe I should actually be using that BCC. So remember, it actually hides blind. It will make sure that the people cannot see, other people cannot see the email addresses of all of the recipients. So I hope that was helpful. So I really hope this instruction has been helpful and is going to help you keep email addresses private in the future. It might pay to make your way to the message tab, turn on your BCC field so that it's always visible, and it's a good reminder when you are sending messages to a group of people. If this has been helpful, please let me know in the comments below. And if you want to stay connected, just hit that like button and please make sure that you subscribe, because we're sharing new videos regularly. And if you know of anyone who could benefit from this, please be sure to share this video with them. Hey, thanks for watching and have a fabulous day.